The aviation industry is a critical part of our world today. In 2019, there were a record 38.9 million flights that transported 4.5 billion passengers around the world. The industry supports tens of millions of jobs and around 4% of the world economy. However, while aviation is crucial to human civilization, it also presents a major threat. In 2019, the industry emitted 918 million tons of carbon dioxide into the atmosphere, around 2.5% of global CO2 emissions. While this number decreased in 2020 due to the coronavirus, from this point onwards, it is only expected to grow. The International Civil Aviation Organization has predicted that, if nothing is done, annual aviation emissions could triple by 2050. This would accelerate climate change, leading to further economic harm and damage to the environment. To solve this issue, the airline industry must change. To help with this, many companies are designing more efficient aircraft and experimenting with alternative fuels, such as biofuel. However, this can only help so much. To completely remove the industry's carbon footprint, aircraft will have to go green. One solution is battery-powered electric airplanes. Battery-powered aircraft have existed for decades. In 1973, Fred Militke and Heino Brichka converted a Brichka HB3 motor glider into the world's first manned electric aircraft, using nickel-cadmium batteries. It flew for only 12 minutes, reaching a max altitude of 300 meters. Over the next two decades, several more prototypes were created. However, with low-performance batteries, they either flew for very short durations or were incredibly lightweight and fragile. Then, in the 1990s, more powerful lithium-ion batteries entered the market. In 2003, the Lange and Terese glider was equipped with a 42-kilowatt electric motor and lithium-ion batteries. It flew to a maximum altitude of 3 kilometers. In 2015, the Solar Impulse plane flew around the world, running entirely on solar-powered lithium-ion batteries. The same year, the startup Eviation was founded. They began work on Alice, an 11-seat luxurious electric airplane with a range of 800 kilometers. Then, in September 2017, the British airline EasyJet announced it was working with Wright Electric to develop a battery-powered 180-seat airliner by 2027. In May 2020, a Cessna 208B Grand Caravan was equipped with batteries and an electric motor. It flew for 30 minutes and climbed up to 760 meters, becoming the largest all-electric commuter aircraft ever. And in September 2020, the Swedish startup Heart Aerospace announced the ES-19, a 19-seat all-electric commercial aircraft that will be ready by 2026. The electric aviation industry is quickly gaining momentum. Boeing, Rolls-Royce, and Siemens are all working on electric-powered airplanes as well. The Eviation Alice already has a finished prototype and is planned to fly for the first time in 2021. In the coming years, electric passenger airplanes will take to the skies, potentially dominating the domestic travel market. They will have some major benefits. The first is wildly cheaper fuel costs. Currently, a small aircraft like a Cessna Caravan spends around $400 on conventional fuel for a 100-mile flight. With electricity, this would be around a mere $10. This would cut operating costs, lowering ticket prices. In addition, with small, lightweight electric motors, instead of large, heavy turbines, electric airplanes would be more attractive looking. Lastly, they would be 100% green, with zero carbon emissions. However, there is still a major issue. These airplane concepts have very low ranges. The Eviation Alice and EasyJet airplanes' 800 and 500 kilometer ranges are approximately the distances from New York City to Columbus and Brussels to Hamburg. The reason for this is battery technology. Lithium-ion batteries have a specific energy, or the amount of energy stored per unit mass, of up to 265 watt-hours per kilogram. Around 10% of this energy is lost by electric motors, leading to a 239 watt-hour useful energy output. However, jet fuel has a specific energy of around 12,000 watt-hours per kilogram. While around 60% of this is lost due to turbine inefficiency, the number is still 20 times higher than batteries. Say you have a typical 41,000 kilogram Boeing 737 with a full tank of 18,000 kilograms of jet fuel. To get the same amount of energy output, you would need 360,000 kilograms of batteries. This would make the airplane so heavy, it would be unable to get off the runway. You could use only 18,000 kilograms of batteries, but this would result in only 1/20th of the energy output, significantly cutting the airplane's range. For this reason, current electric aircraft, even with super efficient designs, cannot travel very far. To get electric airplanes across oceans, batteries must be improved dramatically. Unfortunately, lithium-ion batteries are likely approaching maturity. Any further improvements would probably be marginal. However, other batteries can be improved. Lithium-sulfur batteries, which have a specific energy nearly twice as high as the best lithium-ion batteries, are quickly being improved and could be commercially available within the coming years. In addition, solid-state batteries are quickly improving and could serve as a major upgrade to current technology. These batteries could significantly improve the ranges of electric aircraft, allowing for long-distance domestic flights. However, even this improvement would likely not be enough for long-distance intercontinental flights. In addition, battery-powered planes would use propellers, which are much slower than turbofan engines. Currently, a Cessna Caravan has a maximum cruise speed of 213 miles per hour. In comparison, a Boeing 737 MAX has a max cruise speed of 521 miles per hour. The current 8-hour flight from New York to London would be between 14 to 18 hours with electric planes. To solve this problem, there is another solution: hydrogen. Liquid hydrogen burns with oxygen into water while creating lots of energy. In fact, it has a specific energy of 39,000 watt-hours per kilogram, over 3 times the specific energy of jet fuel. However, for liquid hydrogen, it does have an energy density, the amount of energy stored per unit volume, of 2,770 watt hours per liter. For comparison, jet fuel is 10,080 watt hours per liter. So, for 1 liter of jet fuel, you would need 3.6 liters of hydrogen. However, the jet fuel would weigh 3 times the hydrogen. While hydrogen seems great on paper, it does have some drawbacks. Currently, it is quite expensive, with green hydrogen costing around $6 per kilogram compared to 50 cents per kilogram for jet fuel. This correlates to 15 and 4 cents per kilowatt hour. Fortunately though, economies of scale and advancements in production technology could seriously lower this cost. Another issue is infrastructure. Unlike electric planes, to support hydrogen aircraft, new factories would have to be built, and airports would need to install hydrogen infrastructure. This would result in large setup costs. Furthermore, since hydrogen is a lot less dense than jet fuel, aircraft would need significantly larger fuel tanks. Lastly, to store hydrogen as a liquid, airplanes would need cryogenic systems to keep the fuel below negative 253 degrees Celsius. Despite all this, hydrogen is very promising for the aviation industry. Since it combusts, it could be used with current turbofan technology, accelerating aircraft to high speeds across vast distances. Recognizing the potential of hydrogen, in September 2020, Airbus announced Zeroavia, a project to develop hydrogen-powered passenger aircraft by 2035. As a part of it, Airbus has 3 aircraft concepts with turbofans, propellers, and a mixed-wing design. That same month, the company Zeroavia flew the largest hydrogen-powered aircraft in history, a 6-seat turboprop plane. It hopes to have its first commercial offerings by 2023 in a 200-seat, 5,470-kilometer range hydrogen airliner by 2035. Both battery and hydrogen-powered aircraft are quickly accelerating. They will become commercially available for short domestic flights throughout the 2020s and potentially become widespread during the 2030s and 2040s. Battery-powered airplanes will likely dominate domestic flights between smaller airports. Meanwhile, hydrogen will be used for long-distance flights between large international airports where hydrogen infrastructure will be installed. Both kinds of aircraft will make aviation green, helping transition human civilization into a sustainable future. What do you think? Will battery and hydrogen-powered aircraft transform the aviation industry? Let's talk about it in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, it would be amazing if you like and subscribe for more videos very similar to this one. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.